Chinese example is interesting because it's both past and contemporary. And I like the example of Mr. Wu, who petitioned against the injustice in his steel company. And he was, of course, put in the mental institution 4 years. And this is not isolated case, but more than cliche, because you will find other cases as well, like a nurse. She was also petitioning against some injustice in her hospital. She also ended up being locked in the psychiatric institution. So China is effectively using that tool for silencing the political opponents and silencing people who are trying to do something out of the system, or you know, going against the tide. But you know, guys, question is, what would you do as a spiritual and as an awakened individual if you were living in some Chinese village and all your life changed because big corporation opened big company and now there is like shitloads of chemical waste and people are dying? Would you petition? Would you try to do something legally? Would you react? I bet you would. And this is what would await you: being locked up and electroshocked and beaten and fed with totally chicken shit food and medicated and so on. Just horrible experience, but I guess reality for many Chinese dissidents these days. And of course, practitioners of the Falun Gong, they've been also locked up into mental institutions. People who are guilty for meditating, essentially. Meditation, that was their sin.
近年来，中国大陆不断上演普通民众被精神病的事件。很多人批评精神病院已经成为当局打压上访者和异议人士的工具。最近呢，中共全国人大表决通过精神卫生法，其中规定精神障碍的住院治疗实行自愿原则。那么，这一法律是否能够终结被精神病现象呢？请看本台记者的报道。
11月26号，中共十一届全国人大常委会第29次会议表决通过精神卫生法。这一法律是中国大陆关于收治精神病人的第一部法律，经历27年才得以出台。大陆媒体号称，当初起草这部法律的关键并不是为了防止被精神病，但随着一系列被精神病事件的被曝光，这一内容成为立法的核心问题。 2003年10月，河南漯河农民徐林东因为反映情况，被乡政府强行送进漯河市精神病院，非法关押长达6年半。 2006年，武汉钢铁集团公司职工徐武因状告单位不公待遇而被警方和信访部门送进武钢职工二院精神科，长达4年。 2009年12月，深圳市第二人民医院护士郭俊梅到信访办反映情况，被深圳市康宁医院故意诊断为偏执性精神障碍。 郭俊梅被强行住院治疗，而这部精神卫生法将于明年5月1号实施。其中规定，精神障碍的住院治疗实行自愿原则，自愿住院的精神障碍患者可以随时要求出院，但同时规定，诊断为严重精神障碍患者并且可能危害他人安全的，可以由公安机关采取强制措施。那么，到底该由谁来鉴定精神障碍呢？精神卫生法规定， 诊断应当由精神科执业医师做出，但现实是，大陆的精神病院和精神科医生往往听命于当局，出示假鉴定结果。比如，上述被精神病的郭俊梅就被司法鉴定医师高北林故意诊断为偏执性精神障碍，而武汉钢铁集团公司职工徐武的父母则在警方和信访部门不迁就判刑的巨大压力下，被迫再送儿子到精神病院的文件上签字。今后的话呢？
应该考虑呢，就让相应的这些医疗机构啊，有更大的这个独立性，有更多的专业性，它只对病情和事实负责，而不应该呢掺杂其他的一些因素。
北京律师唐吉田认为，中国大陆每一次权力格局的调整都非常困难，但和生命健康相比，一切都不该成为阻碍。如果说滥用了这个公权力，滥用了。 或者是公权力呢干预、插手这种医疗的活动，插手医疗的这种专业的这种业务范围，那么显然会存在着对当事人权益侵犯的这种现实可能。
网民也质疑精神卫生法能够解决被精神病的问题。有网友表示，
被精神病现象是一种中国现行制度下官本位思想的产物，是这部法律能解决的吗？香港居民朱和明曾经因为起诉江泽民迫害法轮功而被投入监狱，遭受残酷迫害。他认为这部法律有很大矛盾，实际上真正的精神病人基本不会自愿治疗。朱和明说，中共出台精神卫生法只是为了在人权方面掩人耳目，给镇压找借口。当局可以对外宣称所有被关押的人都是自愿治疗的。
他不管什么法律呢，就是绝对不能相信的，他是没有法律的，尤其对在这个迫害法轮功上是没有法律的。现在这么多人被迫害死了，这么多人被送到精神病去迫害，这打的药物，这个精神不正常甚至给迫害死的太多太多了，他从来没有说是按照法律去做什么事情。
朱克明指出，实际上中共体制号称为人民服务，但官员做的很多事情，比如残酷打压抗议民众、贪污腐败、出卖领土、活摘器官等等，都是精神不正常的表现。
Marko Franciskovic is my countryman from Croatia. He's more on nationalist side, and well, it's a good tactic because that made him lots of good friends, and these friends got him out of the psychiatric institution, which is technically just a prison with one ward for the psychiatry, or what I heard in that prison, the so-called, psychiatric prisoners are simply put in the cages, in cells with other inmates, but they just get medical, tranquilizers and that kind of stuff. And his problem, well, of course, he was outspoken. He was writing books. This is the way how to be targeted, right? And in one occasion, he was over the Facebook debating or arguing with the Minister of Internal Affairs, which is big no-no-no in the Reptilian system, right? And he ended up in the psychiatric institution. In that psychiatric institution, the lady doctor said, I browsed through your books, you have many chapters, it's a big book, and this is the proof that you are mentally ill because you suffer from megalomania and you are mentally ill. So this is again example, they use the truth against you, you have a big book, right? That's the truth. Well, how the member of the unholy trinity gonna spin it out? Well, you gotta be crazy, because who else would write such a big book? And who has the right? Well, who's right? Well, again, person who holds the higher ground. Luckily for Mr. Franciskovic, he had big support from NGOs, and his case was out in the media. Well, I'm talking about the internet media, not the regime's media in Croatia. They are like same as medias in your country. However, after about 8 months, he was out. People normally spend their in Croatia up to 4 years. This is maximum they can put you in a prison, psychiatric institution, which is the same, and in the same building. 4 years, but per average they spend about 2 years. And most of the people which ended up there, like Franciskovic, were the veterans of the war 1991-1995. So this is the targeted group in Croatia, because I think like they are semi-organized or organized, they are very outspoken, and they have to the degree lots of respect in the society as the people who fought for the country in that historical period and so on. So I think that was making them dangerous.
Toliko o tom sucu i o tom suđenju, a samo bi još rekao jednu stvar vezano za ovu režimsku psihijatricu.
Da.
Jedan tatar absurda bio, i ona govori kao dokaz, pod navodnike dokaz moje bolesti, kaže da je ona prelistala moju knjigu i da ona ima toliko puno poglavlja da to jedan čovjek ne može toliko puno znati. I to je njoj, eto, zato jer je ona intelektualno limitirana, onda je njoj to dokaz, eto, moje megalomanije, moje sumanutosti i moje bolesti. I sve u svemu, evo, tako je to bilo.
Čuda su... Živio, prijatelji.
Malo si narasao.
Malo što si izašao. Da.
Marko, jes ti to pobjegao? Marko, ovo je sumnjivo, nešto.
Da, ne znam što je ovo. Prvi put.
Mr. Tyrone Dew is the target in the individual from United States of America. He was a very successful internet businessman. He was a millionaire, self-made millionaire. And then, and because of that success, in my opinion, he was targeted by the powers that be with voice-to-skull technology. Excuse me. He suffered incredibly. He lost contacts. He said that he would, for example, mentally start to prepare to have a contact with a potential business partner. And then night before and during that contact, he would be heavily targeted with the voice-to-skull technology. He could not sleep the night before, and the interview would go into a very shitty way, and that's it. And then one thing led to another. Mr. Tyrone Dew ended up on streets as a homeless person, but still fighting on, still raising consciousness and advocating. And then one of those actions in Washington, when he was demonstrating in front of White House, he was after that incarcerated and put into mental institution, and his Jewish doctor tried to convince him that he is crazy. So this is the part of the basically gaslighting. You understand me? When they try to convince you that you're crazy and you're not, this is the purest example of psychopathic gaslighting. And that doctor, and I really have to say this, that in what I managed to find out, good 10% of Jewish people are generationally born Satanists and born in Illuminati. That explains why people have so much difficulties with Jews, as I had as working on board Queen Mary II, for example, as photographer, many tour guides. That explains why these people are so evil, and that explains why they're so rich and protected. But that does not make all Jews part of that system, like born in, right? Only influenced. Okay, so that guy tried to convince him that he's crazy because he's 35 and he is not married, and this is one of the symptoms that he is crazy. Yeah, wow. they will try to find anything, and this is the thing. They use the truth. You're 35, you're single, you gotta be crazy, right? And who's right? Reptile or a member of the Trinity who holds the higher ground. Luckily for Tyrone, he is now out of the prison, but still struggling, still targeted individual, still homeless. And I wish if I were a millionaire, to take under my wings all these people and take care of them.
And I'm out here in front of the Navy Yard, raising awareness about the reality of Aaron Alexis and Myra May's motive. A lot of these people have no idea what directed energy weapons are. And quite frankly, if I wasn't a victim of this, I wouldn't know and wouldn't care about this shit either. So I'll stand out here and try to raise awareness about the effects of directed energy weapons. Microwave technology, not talking about the microwave oven in your house. Extreme low frequency waves, man, these people have no idea. Do what I can to educate them.
Next example is Christian Jax from Germany. He was a leftist and he was a peace-loving guy who was always scribbling some initiatives, and he also made his initiative, his plan for the peace in the Middle East. He mailed it to Angela Merkel. He never got response. So one day he handed over to her personally that letter in her front yard, and he just took off, and that was it. She took the letter, and after that it was in the media that he was stalking her, and he was of course caught and sent to the psychiatric institution, and then he died. And this is not the isolated case in Germany. At the end of this video I'm gonna show you, you're gonna see other names and their short stories, how they've been suicided in the mental institutions and so on. And I have to say, Germany seemingly is a nice, organized, rich country, but in reality it's a dictatorship. And I have to say, in my intuition, while I was traveling through Germany with my eyes open, this was one day of my traveling through the country in 2012, I sensed lots of Illuminati and highly high reptilian energy, and this is very, very hard country to be dissident, because it has such an advanced and well-oiled system.
Christian Jax, as a member of Die Linke, since many years was promoting international peace. He also peacefully promoted understanding between the religions. According to the spokesperson, Christian Jax's peaceful work was influenced by his religious beliefs, for which he publicly is known. District Attorney Lolita Lodenkemper stated in Neuruppin that Christian Jax was not under investigation. It is not known how long Christian Jax will be drugged and forced to undergo psychiatric treatment to cure him from promoting peace. Only 7 months later, Christian Jax was dead. The obituary on his party's homepage states, Christian Jax died on 26th of May 2011, leaving us in desolation. He was a committed pacifist and a passionate critic of the capitalist economy and the organization of the state. He regarded them as non-democratic and obstructing human rights. He was intelligent, well-informed and patient, open-minded and friendly. He is leaving a void. We would have gladly supported him when he no longer was able to bear life. So this looks very much like another member of the opposition having been suicided. One out of a large number in Germany.
What to do is, again, it's your intuitive thing. Do what your intuition tells you to do. I'm doing this, you do your part, right? And I have to say one thing. You see the absence of trash? Everything changed dramatically. This is my little update for my viewers. What happened is that while I was cleaning it, and I really need to show you, see how clean it is. And then one day, after all was cleaned again, there was a pile of garbage, and I took that pile of garbage, put it in a bag, right? And then took that bag and went inside and said to one of the prostitutes in front of the pimp that I'm gonna empty that on her and right there in the massage salon. If they just don't discipline themselves, and they took it seriously, and after that no more garbage, really, no more garbage. So the little digression is that people can be thought, but there are different kinds of people. There are people of the higher consciousness. There are people of the average consciousness, and there are people of the lower consciousness. People of the higher consciousness and average consciousness, they can understand, they can connect things like garbage, flies, eye infections, rats, diapers, smell bad, no good, infections, cockroaches, right? You guys understand that, or if you don't, if you're like children, you can easily understand that by thinking about it and taking it seriously. But people with a lower consciousness, like these prostitutes, they could not understand these things, they could not connect things. I was explaining that from August till May, and they finally understood that they cannot do these things once I use the force of, well, basically bluffing that I'm gonna throw that garbage on them. And this is when they took it seriously. So I empirically proved that people of the lower consciousness, that they simply need disciplining and they simply need force to do something because they cannot understand it. They cannot understand, I'm doing this, this is no good. They can only understand, I'm doing this, but if I do this, then I'm gonna get punished. And this logic they understand, and this is working for them. So, little lesson, right?